Praise the Lord. The problem for the disciples was what? Was that they did not even believe or know that God was with them. But God was with them. He was with them. Praise the Lord. God was with them. God will be with you in the mighty name of Jesus. God will not leave you. God will not forsake you. He will be on point for you in everything that you are doing in the mighty name of Jesus. My brother, my sister, I want to tell you, in everything that we do, God is King. There's that song that lady sang that she's acknowledging him for who he is. Yes, you think he's not there for you. I want to tell you, he is there for you in the mighty name of Jesus. 24/7, he does not sleep, he does not falter, he does not fail. God remains God. Praise the Lord. The third point, Jesus will calm your storm. He will calm your storm. It doesn't matter what you are going through, he will calm your storm. He has done it before. He will do it again in the mighty name of Jesus. At the perfect time, that storm will be calmed. Your ways are not God's ways. Your time is not his time. Whatever it is he's going to do, he will do it in his own time. Praise the Lord. Can we talk to Deuteronomy 31 verse 6? He said, be strong. Deuteronomy 31 verse 6. He said, be strong and of a good courage. God will make you strong in the mighty name of Jesus. Fear not. Every spirit of fear in you will be replaced with boldness in the mighty name of Jesus. Not be afraid of them. Who are they? Are they bigger than God? Whoever it is they are, wherever it is they come from, because you are more than a conqueror, you will be above them in the mighty name of Jesus. For the Lord your God, he it is that going that don't go with you. God will always go with you everywhere you are in the mighty name of Jesus. Wherever it is, his grace does not abound. You will not be located there in the mighty name of Jesus. He will not fail you. He will not forsake you. So why are you afraid? God says he will calm your storm. He calmed the storm in those days. He will do it for you too in the mighty name of Jesus. But know one thing. God is never in a hurry. You can't rush God. Because some of us are not yet prepared for the breakthrough after the storm they are going through. It's only when God sees that you are ready for it that God will now launch you into it. So you have to also work on yourself so that you can begin to experience what God has for you in the mighty name of Jesus. Praise the Lord. God has you in mind. If you think God doesn't have you in mind, you are changing yourself. Why did he create you? And we have been told that we are created in what? In his own image. Why did he create you? God has you in mind. God has me in mind. And God will not leave us in the mighty name of Jesus. If you look at Romans chapter 5, verse 6, it says, for when we were yet without strength, in due time, Christ died for the ungodly. When you didn't even have any strength of your own, when you couldn't even do anything, Christ was there for you. And by your own strength, no man can prevail. And by your own understanding, you cannot move forward. If you want to try it, tell God to leave you alone. How will you wake up in the morning? Or you think it is you that ordered your eyes to open? How will you stand up and walk? It is God that makes every part of your body function. And you say you are going through a storm. Go to the hospital and you will thank God. That what you are going through is even small. Some people are going through something greater. My brother, my sister, your time has come in the mighty name of Jesus. And God is going to see you through in the mighty name of Jesus. That thing that you have been told is impossible, which you have been slaving and laboring for, your time of coming out is now in the mighty name of Jesus. Psalm 56 verse 11, praise the Lord. Psalm 56 verse 11, praise the Lord. In God have I put my trust. I will not be afraid what man can do unto me. Those of you that are afraid of your bosses in the office, and are saying that what will happen, they have become Goliaths in your life. Report that to God, and God will deal with them in the mighty name of Jesus. Don't be confrontational. Don't be rude. Don't be insulting. Go to the Lord in prayer and say, because I know I serve a living God. Promotion comes not from the north, east, south, or west, but from you that is above. You have the hands of the kings in your, the head of the kings in your hands. Turn it to my favor. You'll be surprised. It will be as you have prayed in the mighty name of Jesus. Praise the Lord. The fourth point is only in the storm that we truly understand who Jesus is. And that's why we have to have our storm experience. If you don't go through a storm, you don't know, in America now, how many of them worship God? Because everything is so easy. Everything is so easy. Anytime I have opportunity to travel, I look at them. that. When you spend 2 hours on Ajayi-Ajayi Expressway, in the morning going, in the evening coming, do you even know there's one recreational place? How then can they worship and serve God? Maybe some of us are here today because of what we are going through. We are like, we just must serve Him because we want Him to bless us. Don't just be a hearer of the word. Be a doer of the word. James 1:22. Be a doer of the word. Whatever it is you hear, do in the mighty name of Jesus. In Galatians 6:9, He says you should not be weary of doing good. At times, the storms we are in are self-afflicted because we are not doing good. Everything about you is you, yourself, and I. Even when you are praying only for yourself. You are not your brother's keeper. And you want God to bless you. If He blesses you more, it will be stinginess. And from today, you will change in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. I always tell the workers in training, don't wait for what we have done the other day before you know you have a brother or sister in need. Every day should be your welfare day. Every day be concerned about your brother. It is you that gives that can receive. It is you that gives that God will look upon and say, how will I bless this my daughter? How will I bless this my son? Praise the Lord. Stop excusing disobedience. Praise the Lord. So many of us, we give so many excuses. And I'm in this because my father is this. And I'm in that because my sister is that. And because I didn't go to school. I only have no way. You can chart a course for yourself. You can release yourself from your bondage. You can release yourself into your victory. And God will give you the grace in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. God will give you the grace in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. You can see what happened. The disciples had Jesus with them and they were still afraid. How much more you that cannot see Him physically? But I want to tell you, He's there with you. Call upon Him and He will answer you in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. To pass through the storm, like what we saw in Matthew chapter 7, verse 24 to 27. We don't need to read that again, but I want to bring up 5 points. To pass through the storm, you must anchor the hope of your life on the things that will last forever. Praise the Lord. Some of us are carried away with the things of life. We don't even know what we should appreciate and what we should not appreciate. But we are being told here today that you should anchor your hope. You should anchor the hope of your life on the things that will last forever. From that verse is the house. Focus on the building of the house. How are you focusing on the building of your heart? Of the things of God that you are doing. I want to tell you, my brother, my sister, God will see you too. In 2 Corinthians chapter 5, verse 1. 2 Corinthians chapter 5, verse 1. He says, for we know that if our earthly house of this tabernacle we are dissolved, we have a building of God, a house not made with hands, eternal in the heavens. Your work on earth here, we have a house that is eternal in heaven in the mighty name of Jesus. You will not work or slave or labor in vain in the mighty name of Jesus. You will not depend only on the temporal things, but on the permanent things in the mighty name of Jesus. The second point, build your house on the foundation that can never be destroyed. Praise the Lord. That is the rock. What have you built your life upon? Have you built your life upon what can just come with small temptation and evolve? That is why it's likened to the rock. Establish your life. Establish your hope. Establish everything that concerns you upon the rock. The rock can never fail. Christ is the rock. He will never fail you in the mighty name of Jesus. In 1 Corinthians chapter 3 verse 11, it says, for under foundation can no man lay than it is laid, which is in Jesus Christ. There is no other way. He is the way. He is the truth. He is the life. If you hear any other thing anybody has said, it's a lie. It is a lie. There is no other way but through Christ. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Because of our time, we can write down your Bible passages. The third point is, know that the storms of your life are inevitable. You will go through storms. Problems will come. That is the rain, the flood, the wind. Challenges will come. Even through human beings like you and I, they will want to distract you, to derail you. But you must know where you stand so that you can pass through your storm and you can emerge victorious in the mighty name of Jesus. No matter where it is they come from, God will see you through in the mighty name of Jesus. Wherever it is they gather against you, they will scatter in the mighty name of Jesus. You will pass through in the mighty name of Jesus. may remain. Praise the Lord. Only the things of God will remain in you in the mighty name of Jesus. The word will shake out those things that are undesirable in you in the mighty name of Jesus. Last Sunday we remember we said the blind man removed the cloak. That cloak that is holding you down in bondage, in captivity, will be removed by the word of God in the mighty name of Jesus. The fourth point there, don't settle for the things that are temporary. That's the sand. The sand was temporary. Don't settle for the things that are temporary. Look unto things that are permanent. Look unto the things that will be a blessing for you and your generations to come in the mighty name of Jesus. Don't depend on things that are just, what can just pass away. Praise the Lord. We know that the kingdom of the Most High God can never pass away. Praise the Lord. 2 Corinthians chapter 4. If we look at verse 17, praise the Lord. He says, for our light affliction, which is but for a moment, worketh for us a far more exceeding and eternal weight of glory. While we look not at the things which are seen, but at the things which are not seen. For the things which are seen are temporal, but the things not seen are eternal. You will look unto eternity in the mighty name of Jesus. And because you are focusing on eternity, you will come out of your storm in the mighty name of Jesus. The last point there is cling unto the promises of God, even at your darkest moment. Praise the Lord. Don't say you don't have a darkest moment. Don't say you are perfect. The only one person I know that is perfect is God. And because you are a mortal like me, you are not perfect. Don't say there is no trouble going on. Think very well, and then you will know that, yes, I am going through something. But just as we have in Romans chapter 8, verse 35, praise the Lord. Romans chapter 8, verse 35. It says, who shall separate you from the love of Christ? Shall tribulation or distress, or persecution, or famine or nakedness, or peril or sword? As it is written, for you doubting Thomases, that's what verse 6 says. It says, as it is written, for thy sake we were killed all day long, and we are counted as sheep for the slaughter. Nay, in all these things, we are more than conquerors to Christ that loved us. If you know you are a conqueror, if you know you believe that God indeed is your God, I want to tell you, you are coming out strong. God is going to see you through. That storm in your life, that problem in your life, God will see you through in the mighty name of Jesus. Yes, you have been sick. Every week, you go to the hospital. It is one evil report of the mother. I want to tell you, lay it at the feet of Jesus. You had that mother's testimony. He said he came and he lay on the altar. And he said, Dr. Jesus, perform your own surgical operation. When I go back, let the report be positive. And as it was, he went back there and they said there was nothing wrong with him. I tell you, your own case is not different. Whose reports would you believe? They have said you are barren. They have said you are fruitless. I want to tell you, they have said you are a dunce. They have said you cannot move forward. God wants to move you out. God wants to give you a new name. God wants to elevate you. God wants to promote you. However, to survive your storm, you must know Christ. Praise the Lord. There are some people here. You are going through a lot. It may even be